ادْعُ إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِظَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ وَجَادِلْهُم بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was seen going on the minbar, and this is reported by Abu Huraira and it's authentic, sahih. The Messenger was going on the minbar and he said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. He said Ameen thrice. And after the khutbah, he was asked, why did you say Ameen three times? He said, Jibreel came to me and he made a dua. He made three du'as, and the first dua was, whoever reaches the month of Ramadan and does not have his sins forgiven, may he be cast into the hellfire and may Allah lead him or throw him far away. Imagine this. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said Ameen. Jibreel, a great angel, the angel that was in charge of, you know, giving all the messengers the revelation, he was making a dua, and khayrul khalq, khayrul bariyah, the best of mankind, the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying Ameen. And this dua is, if you, if me, people who are right now in the month of Ramadan, make it to Ramadan and don't have our sins forgiven, may we be cast into the hellfire. What is this trying to show us? The importance of seeking Allah's pleasure in this month. This is, you know, once a year comes. How often do we have the month of Ramadan? How many people die right before the month of Ramadan? You know, a story that I just heard today. There's a brother from Chicago who was listening to a halakha where, you know, they were talking about preparing for Ramadan. And he said, he began to speak and he said, you know, so many times I neglected the month of Ramadan. Inshallah, this Ramadan, I want to make the most out of it. And a few days before Ramadan came, he got into a car accident and passed away at 17 years old. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the blessing of making it to this month. When people who wish to be in this month are not here, the importance, we have to make use of this month. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the entire world on lockdown for us. Nowhere that we can go, nothing that we can do. We're all trapped in our houses. Now Allah is telling you, you have all the time that you can have. All the time you're spending at home. 24/7 you're in your house this Ramadan. You have so much time. We always make the excuse, I don't have time to read Quran. I don't have time to pray in the night. I don't have time to do this. I don't have time to do that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He just gave you all the time that you need. So I ask you, seek Allah's forgiveness. Seek Allah's pleasure. The excuse of time is no longer an excuse. Now it's about discipline. If you don't reach Allah's pleasure in this month, you did not lack time, you lack discipline. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Jibreel made dua against a person like you. So I urge you, I urge myself, let's use this month to read more Quran than we ever did, to pray more in the night than we ever did, to, you know, give more in charity than we ever did. Let's make this the best month in terms of getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and attaining His pleasure. Jazakumullah khair.